Hello, my name is Vedant. I'm a legal intern with Lexis & Company. In this video, we will look at how we can protect trademarks in India and what are the different remedies that are available for protecting trademark in India. So, how to protect trademark in India? Actions which can be taken for protection of trademarks in India include an action against infringement and passing off. So there are four ways in which trademark can be protected in India. First is cease and desist order or notices. Second, civil actions can be taken. Criminal proceeding can be initiated, or four, border measures can be taken. Cease and desist noticed. Misrepresentation and misuse of trademarks without lawful authorization from the IP owner is common in trademark. In our day-to-day lives, we come across several counterfeit and fake products in the market. In view of this rising maniac and its timely prevention, trademark owners have resorted to the means of sending cease and desist letter, also known as cease and desist orders, to the potential infringers prior to approaching the court of law. Sending a cease and desist letter is regarded as an ancillary enforcement strategy to settle a dispute without resorting to litigation or without resorting to the court of law. Most of the time, sending a cease and desist letter is the foremost remedies sought by the trademark owners to prevent trademark infringements. Trademark owners generally rely on cease and desist letter as a cost-effective mean to enforce their right against the infringer and before initiating legal action, with the intent to amicably resolve the matter. Typically, a cease and desist letter will have a following content. First, the business or the trademark portfolio of the IP holder. Second, information about the national and international repute the IP holder enjoys in its trademark. Third, the details of the impinged trademark. Fourth, the extent of misuse of the impinged trademark by the infringer. And lastly, requisition as required to be complied with by the infringers. Prior to sending a cease and desist letter, it is recommended that the IP holder become fully aware of the extent of misuse of its trademark by the infringer and the details of such misuse, keeping in mind the very important factor or the number of years of use by the IP holder. It is also advisable that the IP holder, prior to initiating an action against the infringers by sending a cease and desist letter, carefully looks over its IP portfolio to cover for any sort of vulnerability to its rights. Though sending of a cease and desist letter is viewed as one of the most cost-effective method of addressing an infringement, there are certain risks associated such as, first, suit for guidelines threats, so suit for groundless threats. On the receipt of a cease and desist letter, the defendant may not be willing to admit to the misuse being carried out by him, and rather might initiate a suit for groundless threats against the IP holder or sender of the cease and desist letter in a competent court. Second, ex parte injunctions. Sending a cease and desist letter not only marks the first state of knowledge of being carried out by the infringers, but also simultaneously alarms the infringer that the IP holder is aware of his conduct, which, unless corrected, holds the threat of legal proceedings being initiated against him. Therefore, in such circumstances, the infringers also remain prepared and might take appropriate steps, such as filing a caveat in the appropriate court, which completely diminishes the chances of an IP holder to obtain an ex parte injunction. Fabrication of accounts. It may be noted, and third is the fabrication of accounts. It may be noted that in India, prior use of trademark holds more weightage than prior registration of the same, as a cease and desist letter carries relevant details of the IP holder, such as date of the first use of trademark in India and internationally, and also the date of first registration. Such information, when received by the infringer, can be misutilized by the infringers to alter his or her own accounts or records to show prior use in the said mark. So in this video, we just covered what are cease and desist letter and how this can be used by a trademark owner against a trademark infringer. In next video, we will look at some of other different remedies which are available for protecting of trademarks in India. Thank you.